There is photoshopping and serious editing until we really see people in real life. You see, there's one person who told me that if you want to go on a real date, go take that person for swimming. Take that person for swimming and we see their true colors.
But he's a hot guy, I should say, but when it comes to the looks...
How old is he? Is he like 19, 21?
Yeah, around there.
Yeah.
I've seen his videos when it's not a like real videos, and he looks extremely ordinary. Even Sisa is better.
All right, so let's talk about the people that did not show up in Uganda. Let's talk about Fally Ipupa. What happened to that?
Man.
Wasn't he supposed to perform? So the person who was supposed to bring it.
Because he said
he was supposed to even going to Arua,
yeah.
Mm. Then also there was a party at Atmosphere for Fally Ipupa.
Yeah, but that was with the party was booked in France.
Cut, you see, am I even in Uganda? There's, you see, all these artists that they have put on us this December. You just have to wait until you will see that person arrive at the airport and buy your ticket. Stop buying tickets. Pre-buying.
Are they going to refund the tickets?
Unless it's
money?
A legit company that know that's bringing these people.
But anyway, let me ask you guys, how many Ugandan artists have
Because there's
in
also
Nigeria?
Someone else who was supposed to come this month. Who else is supposed to come? Coffee is coming, I heard. They say. Okay. Okay, sorry. That was a Coffee. I was thinking of Coffee, the Jamaican artist.
It is the Jamaican.
Yeah.
Oh, she's coming.
Okay, rumors she's coming.
Right
now she'll be Nairobi.
Okay. All right. I'm up for that.
How many Ugandan artists are going to be in Nigeria this season for a booking?
Big Thrill,
maybe. Sheba was also there recently.
I don't think she would perform.
Yeah.
We would see that on that. We would see that on social media.
Well, you know, honestly speaking, I think Nigerians do enjoy booking people. Binka has been there. You know,
No way.
Yeah.
It's the opposite. We are booking so many Nigerian artists this year.
Yeah.
And we don't see the value of our Ugandan artists in Nigeria. What's happening?
So who would you want us to deliver to them?
Well, I would want to see at least like 2019 have like five artists. We have so many good artists that can, you know, rock Nigeria. Eddie Kenzo.
Nigeria that I've spoken to, they say they play only
their music.
Like,
they love themselves.
And we're out
than
here playing
else.
Their music, like, you know.
The only person they hear maybe is Diamond.
Mm.
Maybe Diamond.
Mm.
But it's
because it's what they understand. It's what they understand. But, you know, oh well.
And I'm wondering where you're protecting them is what they understand.
I'm not
Do we understand what they
I'm
say?
I'm just getting in their mindset. And Nigerians are just people who are very proud. And I think we should also be proud of our own music. And, you know, instead of, like, paying so much money for these big these Nigerians, let's pay for the concerts that Ugandans have.
Yeah.
Yeah, and support that instead of
Let me tell you, for a company to confirm sponsorship for an artist in Uganda these days is too hard. And it's very easy for these companies to book artists from Nigeria, man.
Well, I want to talk about this week. It's going to be amazing. There's a lot coming up. Mm. I'm going to be hosting an event. That's Era Money. I hope to see you guys on Thursday at Casa de Roy. It's popping. I got you.
She always says that.
Anyway, tickets go for 75,000. Check out Casa de Roy page and go get your ticket because I'm going to be crazy hosting that night. It's going to be massive.
All right. Okay.
So let's say bye to you guys. Coming in from 5 to 7 with all the love, DJ Cisse, MC Kashmir, and your girl Salta. See you guys tomorrow.
Bye-bye. Bye.